Hello friends, welcome to Civil 3D Tips and Tricks channel. In today's video, I am going to show you how you can apply super elevation in the horizontal curves. And I am going to present a series of super elevation videos. So in the next video, I am going to show you how you can apply super elevation in profile views. And in further videos, I will show you how you can apply super elevation in corridors. So let me start the video. So first thing is why we apply super elevation. So the reason for this is, so when your vehicle is moving on particular circular curve, it is having centrifugal force, and because of that centrifugal force, vehicle is going outside the road. So to counter that, what we are doing is we are raising our outside edge so that vehicle will not go outside of the road. Now this is the general diagram how the super elevation is applied. So you can see at the start I am having crown section, so I am having crown at the center, and on the both side I am having normal camber. You can see different points are here. So this is TS, SC, CS, ST again. So what these points mean, so if you want to see that, you can go to the setting and you can click on the edit drawing settings. There you can see abbreviation menu. So here the point meanings are given. So how these points generally work, so the first letter represent what is behind this point, the last point represent what is after this point. So let's say for example this TS, this means before this point there is a tangent and after this point there is a spiral. Now the next one is SC, so before this point there is a spiral and after this there is a circular curve. Same way CS, before this circular and after this there is a spiral. And similar way ST, spiral and tangent. So this way this point labels are used. So when you label your alignment, you can see these points. Now the next thing is this runoff and runout distance, and this is full super elevation. So this full super elevation has been applied in the circular curve portion, and this value is known as E, and this is based on speed and your curvature. So different values given for each country, there is a different table, so you can refer that table, and based on that this E value has been calculated. Now you can see here there is a one-sided slope, and at this point there is a two-sided slope. So this edge will rotate gradually, and this is called the rate of attainment. So each country is having specifications for this rate of attainment, what should be the limit for this. And you can see this point, at this point there is a level, means zero crossfall. So at this point is known as the LC, level crown. So after this point up to the full super elevation, the distance is known as the runoff, and this is known as the runout. So we will see this in detail in super elevation view, but this is the general terminology use, runoff and runout in the super elevation. So this is way the super elevation has been calculated. So let's see different examples, and in this example we are having spiral curve. Sometimes there is no spiral curve, so we will see how we can apply the super elevation in that situation. So I have drawn two alignments here. So you can see this alignment is having spiral curve, and this alignment is not having spiral curve, only circular curve is there. So this is the super elevation view for this alignment, and this is the super elevation view for this alignment. So when you select the alignment, you will get this option. So I will show you how to calculate this one, but before that I will show you some of the points which is coming in super elevation view. So you can see this, I am taking this as an example, this is having spiral. So you can see on the left hand side, these are the different crossfalls. So generally for the crown road, all the roads will have either -2% or 2.5%. So you, on the both side will start from either 2% or 2.5%. So here if I go to super elevation view properties, for left outside lane I have given green color, and for right outside I am using blue color. So at this location both are having the same -2.5% slope. And this BOA means the beginning of alignment. So this is represent zero change. Now if I go to the next point, so this is ENC. So you can see up to this point there is a normal crown, and after this point my left outside lane is rotating. So this point is known as ENC. This is end of normal crown. So after that one lane will start rotating. Now the next point is LC. This is level crown. So up to this point it is having means minus 2.5 to 0%, and after this the slope will be in the positive. So this point is known as the level crown, where we are having zero crossfall. And you this point is also describe what is the runoff distance and what is runout distance. So if you see crossfall wise, so in this portion my one side crossfall is not as per normal camber, but it is still negative. So my fall will be outside of the road, and after this point my fall will be towards the median side. So this is known as the runoff distance and this is runout distance. Now the next point is RC. So this is reverse crown. So you can see on the right hand side there is no change up to this point. After this point it is start rotating. So this is known as the reverse crown. After this both lay edges will rotate. And this is BFS, beginning of full super elevation. So after this point the full super elevation required at the circular curve has been applied. And this is EFS, so end of full super. So it is the reverse exercise. So after that there is a reverse crown. So after that only one side will rotate. This is level crown. So at this point I am having zero crosswall, and this is again beginning of normal crown. So this is way the outside edge will rotate. And if you are doing for the shoulders, there will be one more point code. So like BNC, there will be BNS, beginning of normal shoulder and end of normal shoulder. So this way, these are the point codes, and how this I have been used while you are doing super elevation calculation, I will show you. So the first thing for calculating super elevation, you need the design speed. So if you go in the alignment properties, I have assigned 65 speed here. And I am using criteria based design. So this is my country kit. So I am using IRC. If you have not seen our country kit video, please visit at the top link. So if I go to the browse, you can see I have used the India country code. I am using this IRC SP84 plane and rolling terrain, 2 to 4 lanes. I am not using 6 lane. So this way the parameters has been set up. And how this will work, so I open this file. So this is land XML file. So if I see this one, so it is as per the table has been created based on plane and rolling terrain. So you can see the different codes are defined here. So E is the full super elevation, C is the normal crown, then S is the normal shoulder slope. Now there's a different method given here. So for LC to FS, what is LC to BC, and different formulas are given. Like for NC to FS, it's T minus TC divided by E, and these parameters are given here. So T means the transition, then E means super elevation. So for different point codes, like for LC to FS in the planar, this is the formula T. Now LC to BC, the formula is P into T. So this way the software is calculating. And there is one more table for different design speeds. Like I am using 65 design speed. So if I am having radius of 150 meter, then my super elevation requirement is 5. If I am having 500, then it is 3.75. So this way the software is calculating. So let me do this. So this is my design speed is applied. So what I will do is I will go to calculate edit super elevation. In that there is a tabular editor, and I will delete this super elevation. So my super elevation has been deleted. Now if I close this one, I can create it from here also, but I will show you from the start. So when I select the alignment, calculate edit super elevation, calculate super elevation. So it will give me four options. I can do it for the undivided crown. So the crown is having a center at center of the alignment, and in the planar we are having one-sided slope. So I will select undivided crown. If you are having divided crown, you can use this one. Now the next thing is lane. So you can see that I haven't created profile or corridor. So for calculating super elevation, you don't need profile or corridor, but for calculating the rate of attainment and everything, you have to specify the normal lane width. So I am specifying normal lane width 7 meter, and my slope is minus 2.5 meter, 5%. Now if I select unsymmetrical roadway, then it will be tick for both sides. And if I untick this one, so I have to specify different parameters for the left hand side as well. So I will choose the symmetric. I will not calculate shoulder, but you can calculate for shoulder as well. And this will create two more super elevation for the left hand side super elevation and right hand side super elevation. And you can even specify shoulder rollover. So after that super elevation, your edge will not rotate. And here you can specify different methods for shoulder rate of attainments. And the last thing is you have to specify this file, and here you have to specify for the tangent curve what will be the rate of attainment, and for the spiral curve what will be the rate of attainment. This is to apply curve smoothing. So wherever your kinks are there, it will apply one curve. So you can specify that, and when you are having back to back curves, you can resolve the overlap. So just let me finish this one. So it is calculating the super elevation. So now if you see, the super elevation has been calculated 5%, and it is applied for the entire curve, and this is my spiral. Now if you see here, this is where I am not having the spiral. So you can see the super elevation has been divided. So in this much portion the full super elevation is applied, but the level crown to beginning of full super portion has been divided in three parts, and two-third part is applied here and one-third part is applied here. So where you are not having the transition, it will calculate as per this two-third one-third method. And if you select the curve, so it will provide curve here, and in this option I have not selected curve, so it will give us like this. So you can see the 5% super elevation. Now these are the lengths based on lane value we have given. Now if I go to my alignment, and if I do change my radius, so currently the radius is 200 and the transition is 60-60. So if I refer this table, so let me try this one. So for 400 rate is required 4.69. So let's say I will choose 400, and my super layer transition length is 30 meter on both sides. So you can see based on this the super elevation has been modified, but the full super elevation value is still 5%. So if you select your alignment and go to calculate and edit, you can see that this is super elevation is out of date. This is not calculated based on this updated parameters. So if I recalculate this one, it is calculated based on that spiral what we have specified. So lot of people, what they are doing is they will export this super elevation to the Excel, then they edit it, then again they will import it. So there is no need to do that one. So similar way, if you don't want to use IRC, let's say I will use ASTO standards, and I will use my formula, and I will recalculate, then it will calculate as per ASTO. So as per ASTO, my super elevation is 3.7%, and it will calculate the other points based on that. So let me again calculate it by IRC. Now Now you can see this LC point is almost at the spiral length. This is because I have keep this spiral length near to minimum only. If I am having lesser spiral length, then it LC point will not be at the same location. Generally, if you keep this LC point at the end of your spiral, then it will be good design. It will be also good for the drainage team for calculating drainage related calculations. So this way you can apply super elevation for different conditions. And yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. In the next part, we will see how we can apply this super elevation, how we can apply the super elevation in the corridors, and how we can show that into the profile view bands. Thank you.